1 millimeter in their growth per year. It's like relatively normal sized trees are actually so ancient.
On the right hand side though, another human pine. This one's closer to 900 years old.
Great example of what those early pioneers would have been looking for. That's relatively tall and straight and knotless, so it was bent for shipbuilding. This is bone. However, by far the oldest human pine we have here at Heritage Landing, it's actually the log that's lining the boardwalk behind you all. It would have originally stood in that corner of the boardwalk in a V-shape, chained down in the storm about 23 years ago. And this tree was dated by a dendrochronologist to be 2,300 years of age when it came down in that storm.
Now, remarkably, if you were to cut into this tree, you'd still find that the timber was perfectly preserved and still usable. That's due to the presence of the methyl eugenol oil I spoke of earlier. What allowed these trees to grow to such a great age is what made them so successful in the shipbuilding industry.
Even though this tree is now dead, it's still serving a really important purpose here in the forest.
Over the 23-year period since it's fallen,
as you can see, organic matter has broken down to form a layer of soil.
That's allowed over 140 endemic species of plants, moss, fungi, lichen, and other trees to all establish a home here.
We've got pretty much all of our species growing off this log here.
Just one other cool fact about this tree though is that it looks almost known as the mother tree. It's got a really expansive root system that covered most of the area we're standing in now. There's something really cool that human plants can do with their root systems when they're exposed to the right conditions. It's called vegetative reproduction. Dry sunlight and some water make them produce genetic copies of themselves. This is actually what happens with this grove over here. If you look down at their base, you'll see they're all connected at the root. That's some fantastic evidence that they're all functioning. They're about 2 millimeters big, and they generally just look like discoloration on the end of the foliage.
So the growers, not showers,
they only produce them after 500 years of age.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you.
think there's any.
my goodness. What's out there?
It's a big black cat cockatoo.
Oh, okay.